Hi guys, this is Bretman Rock, and this is a story about the time I almost murdered somebody at a party. JK, but not really. Kind of. Almost. I did. As you guys know, I'm a pop star. I was on tour in Oregon and I was, you know, scheduled to perform the next morning, but I had a free day. So I had a friend that went to college in Oregon and I was like, hey homegirl, what the f is up tonight? Let me know. She hit me back literally 1.6 seconds later and she said, homegirl, we have a party tonight. Be there or be squared. And I ain't no square, I'm a motherfucker. Circle. So my friend who went to that college was actually a part of my high school track team. She had mentioned that it was going to be a track party with the rest of her team. You know, I had to fit the occasion, fit the theme. I still wanted to give you Sporty Spice realness, but very humble. Like she's just going to Pilates. So I was wearing this light blue shirt with these gray compression pants. So yeah, I was giving you, you know, lounge wear. So we pull up at the party. So 10 minutes in, I took 2 cups of jungle juice down that and then I was taking jello shots and shots upon shots because I was like, girl, I'm here for a mission. I'm gonna get drunk as fast as possible. At one point, I was looking around and I'm like, oh my God, the amount of people here doubled and there had to be like 30 people in a 2-bed dorm room, bitch. I could not breathe. We were all in the living room and it started to get really, really crowded. And so I had the bright idea. I was like, girl, we're in Oregon and you know what's legal here? Weed. So bitch, me being me, you know, I'm a little selfish and I was like, girl, I don't have enough weed to go around everybody. So I gathered a couple of my homegirls, the cutest bitches at the party. I was like, y'all, I got weed. Where can we smoke? And they were like, not in this dorm. And I was like, well, bitch, you didn't say not in these stairs. So we went in the stairs and we started, you know, ganja burning. And so we're smoking, you know, I'm trying to prove to these bitches that, you know, I am a senior smoker. Like, I know my I know my strains, I know my weed. So I was smoking and smoking until somebody who I will not say who smoked a little too much. Some bitch with initials of BR smoked a little too much and she started swallowing the smoke and she started coughing and coughing and motherfucking coughing. When I was, I mean, when BR was coughing, she was coughing as if like she was trying to cough like her livers out and her lungs out, girl. She was coughing her life out of her, like she was ready to give birth through her mouth. Needless to say, she was litty, but she knew damn well deep down inside that body of hers, that skinny body of hers, that she was gonna puke any moment now. So the girls who dorms it was, there were so many people, so she kicked all of us out and we all just like scurried. We literally looked like cockroaches, like trying to leave the room. In literally 5.3 seconds, that dorm went from 30 people to just her. Woo-hoo. It was intense. So I, who is, you know, Miss BR, was swallowing my puke at this moment. Like I was trying to run to the elevator. So all of the people at the party piled up in the elevator together, literally cramped up, all 30 of us, in the tiniest elevator I've ever seen in my whole entire life. So it starts going down for maybe a couple seconds and all of a sudden it just stops. Everyone is literally going bananas. Everyone is pressing every button in the elevator. And there was this one girl with like 3 eyebrows. I don't even wanna get started with her makeup. She started crying, crying her eyes out as if like somebody hit her or something. So this girl just keeps crying and crying and I'm like, oh my God. And I'm like, bitch, if you don't want me to puke on you, you better stop crying right now. So there were these straight guys in the elevator thinking they're all cute and smart. You know how straight guys all think they're all cute and smart. They were like, oh my gosh, let's all jump all at once and maybe it'll take us to the first floor. Us all being drunk and delusional, we were all like, oh my God, that makes sense. Like, duh, let's all jump at once. So all of a sudden, everyone starts jumping and jumping and jumping, doing hopscotch on that bitch. And crying girl is crying and crying and crying. And the jungle juice in me was coming up and up and up. So half an hour later, somebody was like, oh my gosh, let's call the cops. And in my head, I'm like, why the f did we not do that in the f first place. Honestly, at one point, everyone was calling the cops and they were just taking their sweet ass time. So finally, after 45 grueling minutes, we finally feel the elevator going down. Everyone starts cheering, everyone starts jumping even more. So as everyone was stepping out, the last girl was obviously the crying girl. And as she was halfway through, the elevator just falls, dropped, and her body sliced in half, y'all. I'm just kidding, that didn't happen. But what I did fail to mention is that while we were all coming out of the elevator, I basically threw up my breakfast, lunch, and dinner, all the jello shots, all the jungle juice, and the smoke all over her. That's just honestly the last thing I remember from that night. That's why I only take the stairs now. You burn a few calories off, and you don't have to deal with being stuck in the elevator. Oh, I saw you there. I was just tuning my ukulele. Hi guys, it's me, Bretman Rock, and I'm a singer, songwriter, actor, actress, athlete, activist, a scientist on the side, and now I'm an MTV star here to tell you the greatest party story ever. And that's on period.
Well, that was perfect.
Oh, wait, was that an actual take?
Yeah, that was a take.
Oh, that was me practicing. Gosh.